Metaverse, non-fungible tokens, cryptocurrencies, decentralized autonomous organizations, blockchain are words today we hear almost everywhere. In fact, after Mark Zuckerberg's speech, many wondered about the meaning of the so-called virtual reality, a digital place where you can create your avatar and meet the avatars of your friends, buy virtual objects through digital money, and live amazing experiences. Alright, let's keep our feet on the ground. If you really want to understand the topic, I suggest you keep watching the video, as I will walk you through a simple explanation. Ready? Then smack a like and let's go! Starting from the blockchain, we can easily define it as a database where information is stored in digital format. Usually, blockchain collects information together in groups, known as blocks, which have certain storage capacities. When filled, they are closed and linked to the previous filled blocks, forming a unique chain of data. Based on that, the blockchain technology stands out for some key features. Disintermediation, which means the absence of a central authority. In fact, the need that drives people to rely on blockchain is to bypass the cost of guarantor institutions. Decentralization. Information on the blockchain platform is distributed on nodes scattered across the network. This feature makes it a true alternative to centralized financial intermediaries. Immutability, which means data is not modifiable. A change to any block in the chain will invalidate the entire transaction. Traceability. Every item on the blockchain ledger is traceable, implying that we can trace the exact origin of each transaction. Validation, which means transactions will have to be approved by miners through a consensus mechanism, ensuring their validity. Okay, that's the theory. Let's see how blockchain works in a practical example.
I want to send money to you. The transaction is represented online as a block. The block gets distributed across the network. The network verifies the transaction is valid. The block is added to the chain, reconciling across the network and creating a permanent record. My record of ownership of the money moves to you.
These cryptographic techniques have paved the way for cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin and Ethereum. Yes, the name is fascinating, but actually, what are they? In short, they are virtual currencies whose value is hidden by a computer code that allows you to use them only if you have the access key. These features make crypto a suitable form of payment for the metaverse. It will be enough to have a wallet and choose the virtual currency to rely on. However, one aspect to watch out for cryptocurrencies is the sharp fluctuation in their value, as they have no legal cost and are not regulated by central government bodies. Do you invest in crypto? And how is your experience with that? Just comment below, I'd love to know more. Besides crypto, you have surely heard of NFTs lately. What do these three letters stand for? NFTs mean non-fungible tokens, and they represent pieces of digital content, such as, but not limited to, videos and images. NFTs are unique and not mutually interchangeable, unlike cryptocurrency, which instead can be exchanged with another identical one of the same value. When these innovations are grafted into the procedural organizational context, they give life to the so-called DAOs, Decentralized Autonomous Organizations. Technically, a DAO aims to encode the operating rules of an organization in a computer program, the smart contract, which behaves like paper contracts with the great advantage of allowing the management of transactions in a pre-programmed and automated way. In practice, the DAOs allow us to digitize not only transactions, but the actual functioning of an organization starting from preset rules without centralization. The metaverse doesn't only express virtual reality as an access point to video games, but it opens the doors to the society of the future. an economic society shaped with digital and functioning with algorithms, where data and encryption will be elements of confidence, identity, and transparency. What many are calling post-digital society is on its way. A society where we will no longer pay attention to digital because, as it happens today for electricity, it will be a constant and fixed component of our life. But what do we gain as human beings? Well, apart from the playful aspect linked to living a much more immersive experience than is possible with a smartphone, the real gain is autonomy and independence. We will return to the center of the scene as actors and no longer just as spectators. If you enjoyed this video, feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel as more will come shortly. Plus, head over to deltalogics.blog and stay up to date with all about the digital world. Thanks for watching and see you soon. Ciao!